So my boyfriend asked me to marry him, and I'm realizing that even though we've talked about money throughout our relationship and we already live together and share costs, there are still so many money talks we still need to have now that we're getting married. And so I wanted to talk through them here because I think that what happens when we start thinking about marriage and money, the conversation so often goes immediately to the wedding and the budget for the wedding and maybe the honeymoon. And yeah, those things should absolutely be part of the conversation. But as we all know, weddings and honeymoons are just the start of a marriage. And so we wanted to take some time to step back and consider our money within the context of the rest of our marriage and think through all the money moves we need to make to protect and support our relationship and ourselves for the long term. Now, before I dig into all the new money talks we're having now that we're getting married, I wanted to rewind for a second and talk about some of the money talks we've already had in our relationship. Because if you haven't had some of these discussions yet, your engagement is a really great opportunity to initiate them. So, number one is to talk about your money views and your money goals. We all grow up having very different experiences with money based on how our parents handled money, based on the messages we heard about money in our communities, based on our life experience. And so, our beliefs around money, which ultimately inform our financial actions, decisions, and goals, are often very different from those of our partner. And that's fine, that's expected. But what's not fine is not taking the time to talk through those respective beliefs, views, and goals before you get married, so you have the opportunity to get on the same page. Now, this isn't to say that you and your partner have to agree on everything, but you do need to be able to come to an understanding around things like your priorities, values, and goals, and how you're going to use money as a tool for affording those things. Much like you wouldn't want to wait until after you're married to find out that your partner has no interest in having children when you want to have a big family. You don't want to wait until you're already married to find out your partner doesn't really see the value in saving money or planning for the long term when you want to hit big money goals like buying a house or retiring someday. Now, the second major money talk to have before getting married, and ideally even before getting engaged, is the talk about your full financial picture. This means sharing information like your credit, your debt, and your income with your partner, because these financial details and differences have the potential to affect both of you, especially as you move into marriage. For example, if your partner has bad credit and you're going to be moving in together, you'll want to know that before you go apartment hunting and start filling out lease or mortgage applications where your partner's bad credit could hurt your likelihood of approval. Now, reviewing your credit reports together can also tell you whether your partner is making an effort to improve their financial habits, or whether missing payments and skipping out on bills is an ongoing problem. Sharing this kind of information can point to potential pain points in your financial future together and give you the opportunity to work through them as a team. Not talking about these things and keeping things hidden, like overspending and secret debt, can eventually break down the trust that's really essential for the growth of your relationship. On the flip side, open and honest discussions of your financial failures and your financial goals can bond you as a team, even when you disagree, by building a foundation for you to handle problems and challenges together. Okay, number three is logistics. How are we actually going to manage our money together? Now, my fiance and I have already had this conversation when we moved in together and decided how we were gonna split and manage our bills. But now that we're getting married, we're revisiting this conversation and asking ourselves questions like, what types of shared accounts do we want and need? Who's gonna be in charge of what bills? Is there a certain dollar amount above which we shouldn't spend without talking to each other first? Do we like the way we're handling our money? Is our spending plan working for us? Do we need to revisit how we spend and save? And how often should we revisit our finances as a team? Now, we haven't figured out the answers to all of these things, but these are the questions that we're working through now that we're getting married. And I'm sure we'll continue to work through them and revisit these questions throughout our marriage. But regardless of how we ultimately divide our accounts and financial tasks, I know we'll both be fully involved in the process. All right, number four, legal questions. I know it doesn't make me much of a romantic to say this, but it doesn't make it any less true. Marriage is a legal contract. love, faith, family, whatever else you choose to associate with marriage is your business. But at the end of the day, it is a contract. And like any other legal agreement you enter into, there are implications to consider. For example, tax implications. We have an accountant to help walk us through the process of filing our taxes jointly once we're married. We'll also be updating our beneficiaries on things like our retirement accounts. We'll be thinking through how we can protect our assets and estate and what financial and legal documents we might need in case of an emergency. I won't be changing my name, but if you choose to, you'll need to update your essential documents like your driver's license, your social security card, your passport, and your voter registration. Finally, we'll be signing a prenuptial agreement so that should we ever need to separate, knock on wood, our finances get split up the way we want rather than the way the state of New York, where we're getting married, dictates. So while it might not be as exciting as touring wedding venues, talking through the legal steps and changes you need to make before or as you get married is definitely, in my opinion, one of the most important conversations you can have. Okay, number 5. Again, this isn't one of the most exciting talks to have when you're getting married, but it is one of the most important. And that is, how do we protect ourselves and our loved ones? When we get married, ultimately what we're saying is that we're in this together for the long haul. And because of that, we really do need to plan appropriately. Because now if something happens, it's not just about us, it's about our spouse, it's about our growing family, and it's about our growing assets. So with all of that in mind, we're talking about how we can build a financial safety net that extends beyond our emergency funds. So to start, we're reassessing our health insurance coverage. So when you get married, you can either choose to keep your current healthcare plan, join your spouse's plan, or have your spouse join your plan. You want to consider how these changes could affect your premiums, your deductible, and your potential out-of-pocket costs. Now, thankfully, my fiancé has great health benefits, so I am super excited to be getting on his plan. The other question we're reassessing now that we're getting married is what types of insurance we need. So we already talked about health insurance, but beyond that, we don't really have a lot right now because we don't really own a lot. We don't own a home or anything, but we do have some significant retirement savings, both of us, and we both have substantial incomes. And we're also moving into this new phase in our lives where we will likely have children, potentially go on to buy a house, and probably have our financial demands increase. So we're considering our life insurance and our disability insurance options because as careful as we are about making sure our lifestyle upgrades stay within our means, the reality is that all of our financial progress could be totally derailed if something were to happen to one of us. So we're using insurance as an added safety net to make sure we don't find ourselves in a situation where one of us has to suddenly shoulder the cost of our dual income lifestyle alone. We like to think about our life insurance policy and disability policy along with our healthcare coverage and emergency fund as the financial safety net that protects all of our other financial plans, especially as we begin to aggressively pursue our major life milestones like getting married. So to recap, the 5 money talks you need to have before you get married. 1, money views and money goals. It's okay if they're different, but you want to make sure you get to a place where you're on the same page before you get married. 2, full financial disclosure. Credit, debt, income, these are things about your partner that are going to have an effect on you when you get married and vice versa. So it needs to be out in the open. 3, logistics. How are we actually going to manage money in our marriage? Shared accounts, separate accounts, rules, boundaries, expectations, responsibilities, all things to discuss. 4, legalities. What documents do we need to have in place? What changes do we need to make? And what are the implications to consider? And finally, 5, protection. Based on where we are and where we're headed, what types of protections and policies do we need to have in place so we can pursue our financial plans and enter into our marriage with as much peace of mind as possible? Now, speaking of financial plans and life milestones, if you are watching this video before November 20th, 2018, I'm excited to share that I have partnered with USAA on their Live Your Dream sweepstakes, and you can enter to win $50,000 toward whatever life milestone you are currently working toward. Personally, $50,000 would help a lot with my wedding planning, and whatever it is you're working toward, I'm sure it would help you too. So you can check out the link in the description below to see how you can enter to win the Live Your Dream sweepstakes from USAA. In the meantime, let me know what money talks you've had and what financial changes, if any, you've made to support your own life milestones in the comments below. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you learned something helpful, hit the thumbs up button, hit share. I'll catch you next time.